So, my dear brothers and sisters, we are the gift of the Holy Spirit, the gift of counsel. Let me begin with a small prayer. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Heavenly Father, bless and thank you for the gift of the Holy Spirit to us. As on the Pentecost day, as you sent us the Paraclete and filled the hearts and minds of the disciples with the Holy Spirit. And the same Spirit continues to work among us. And today we pray in a very special way for the gift of counsel, the gift that can change our life, because it's the Holy Spirit is the great counselor, and He uses us as instruments to counsel others. We make this prayer to Christ our Lord. Amen. So, my dear friends, I speak about counsel today, another beautiful gift of the Holy Spirit. We all know what is counsel. We can say it's a good advice, and we need it. You know, today's world is not a one-man show. We need many people to interact with us. When you are starting a business, you need to consult many people. You need to be counseled by many. You have to see the different aspects of life. When you are on a particular road of life, when you are beginning something, you need counsel. And perhaps counsel can not only help you to go forward, it may also help you to stop where you are going, change your direction, start a new way of life. And that is called counsel. Counseling is very important. And this word counseling is much used today. We speak about counseling for a job, counseling for a career, counseling for an exam. And so what do we mean by counsel as a gift of the Holy Spirit? May I give you one small example? In fact, this example was given by the Holy Father Pope Francis himself in one of his general audiences on 7th May 2015. Pope says when he was in Argentina, in one of the dioceses there's a mother who came to him and said that, "My son, I don't know what to say. He has grown long hair. He has got earrings here. He has got this there," which means he has become so much modern and this one that he doesn't listen to me. And he's in a deep, deep problems of perhaps drugs or something like that. And I don't know what to do. And the Pope says, I don't know what to do. But there's one thing I can tell you, he says, call your son. He still listens to you. You still talk to him. And tell him to entrust himself to Mother Mary. Because this boy also wanted to change. He was fed up of his life. And therefore, perhaps, we're praying to Mother Mary, you tell him. And the woman called her son and said, "Son, it's not that I don't want to help you, but there is someone who can help you much more, Mother Mary." And therefore, she taught him how to pray the rosary and pray devotedly. And the Pope says, she comes after a long time, after a year or so, smilingly and said, "Your counsel was very good." And the Pope tells her that your counsel to your son was very good also, because Mother Mary did this small miracle in your life, and that is counsel. Telling people what to do, when to do, how to do, that is good counsel. Let us just see what the scriptures speak about the counsel. You know, in the book of Proverbs, we hear, "I am wisdom, I have insight, I have knowledge and sound judgment, and therefore I am able to provide you with good counsel." And therefore, one of the things that is most required for counseling is relationship. Relationship. You don't rush to anybody and ask for a counsel. You don't ask for an advice. The deeper the problem, or the greater the strings, or perhaps the cobwebs that are there, the more you try to release these knots, as it were, with a person known to you. Relationship. Intimacy. That is more important. That is much more important with God. And therefore, the book of Proverbs says that this is possible when you have intimate relationship with God. With the gift of counsel, the Holy Spirit speaks to us and speaks to the heart. It's not that a language, perhaps words that are important, but we get a special message. In an instant, enlighten the person what to do. The book of Psalms can be considered the book of counsels. You know, we have this 150 Psalms, and each Psalm for an occasion, you are sad and the book admonishes you that you can do this. You are in danger, you can do this. You are going for a good work, you can do this. You are going on a journey. This is the way the book of Psalms can be called the book of counsels. Psalm 73 verse 24 says, "You guide me with your instruction, O Lord, and at the end you will receive me with honor." Because when I listen to God's counsel, God blesses me. So therefore the book of Psalms, which we should use often, is a book of counsels. Jesus, of course, is the best model of our counsel. You know how many times the disciples go to him, how many times they ask him questions. We see that at the Last Supper, there is this Apostle John who is leaning on the breast of Jesus and perhaps asking him something, asking him some doubt of his. So this relationship with Jesus and the apostles, and therefore Jesus is the best model for counsel. He is, first of all, Jesus is in counsel or communication with the Father. How many times in the Gospel of Luke we see the end of the day or beginning of the day, Jesus is found at a lonely place. He is found in the mountain. He is found in the deep woods, or perhaps a lonely place, because he wants to pray. He wants to consult. He wants to be counseled by the Father. And at the same time, Jesus counsels the disciples what to do, how to do, how to go about. And many a time we see that they are lost. They are lost, but Jesus shows them the way. In every of his teaching, he has given advice for them. And there are some things which are pointedly told to the disciples. There are some in general. But in everything, there is an aspect of counsel, the gift of the Holy Spirit. And when they are in problems, Jesus tells them. Perhaps the disciples don't understand what are problems, because they think to be with Jesus is the greatest thing for them, is a sign of a victory for them. But Jesus warns them of the hard days, of his days of suffering, and that they also would have to suffer. The disciples also would have to suffer. In Matthew chapter 10 verse 19, Jesus warns them, when they hand you over, do not worry how to speak or what to say. What you are to say will be given to you when the time comes. Because it is not you who will be speaking, the Spirit of your Father will be speaking in you. It's a beautiful counsel that Jesus gives. Surely, perhaps this particular sentence must have given a lot of inspiration to the disciples after the Pentecost, because they faced the danger at every moment, at every day as it were. And in this way, Jesus had prepared them for the battle, as it were, with the world, and also the final battle. And, you know, one of the persons whom we need to seek counsel is Mother Mary. Mother Mary. In the litanies, you know, we have the different titles for Mother Mary. And there's a beautiful title to say is Mother of Good Counsel. Mother of Good Counsel. So Mother Mary is the best counselor for us. And she understands, she surely understands best for us. We see how Mother Mary spends, or rather utilizes, her time and energy, you know, to counsel the disciples. And especially when Jesus is gone, when Jesus is resurrected and gone, ascended into heaven, Mary takes over, as it were, to counsel them, the disciples who are frightened. And many times in the Acts of the Apostles, we see that Mary gathers along with them to pray, to counsel them, to give them courage. And in that way, she is the mother of good counsel. Perhaps one of the ways, or one of the scenes that we have could see, was in the Mother Mary's characteristic of being a counselor, was in the episode of Cana. In the Cana, where Mother Mary tells those that are there, do whatever he tells you. meaning to say that whatever Jesus tells you, that is the best advice for you. That's the best command for you. So in that sense, you do whatever he commands to you. And Mother Mary, as Mother of Good Counsel, tells us the same thing. Do whatever he tells you. And perhaps God's inspiration, God's counsel comes to us in the Holy Scriptures, through our companions, through our family members, through our prayer groups, through those perhaps our liturgies, and many places and many times God counsels us in different ways. And when we are counseled by God, surely we become the best counselors for the others who are in need of counsel, help, support, direction in our life. There are so many people who ask us for counsel, and we are able to counsel them only when we seek counsel with God. And like Jesus, if we have this day divided in a way that we can spend some time every day with the Lord, surely we will be counseled. And Mother Mary, as our also good counselor, and the disciples, the saints, as it were, as our models, we have many, many counselors among us. May the Holy Spirit be blessed, as it were, for this gift for us that we seek from God. Heavenly Father, we thank you especially for this gift of counsel that you give us to the Holy Spirit. We are in need of counseling ourselves. Many a time when we are in problems, when we are in difficulties, when we do not know whom to go and where to go, we need to be counseled. We need your support. We need your inspiration. And especially when the road is difficult, when trials and temptations come, to seek the advice, to seek the counsel of others, we need your help, we need your support. And therefore, give us the spirit of counsel, the spirit of understanding, the spirit of the Holy Spirit, so that in everything that we do, we are always obedient to the will of God. Mary, our Mother, Mother of Good Counsel, give us that grace to understand. And as you counseled Jesus in all times, even perhaps in his public life when he was in problems, we ask a special grace for each one of us, that you be our Mother in case of our difficulty, to counsel us what to do, especially in our families. We make our prayer to Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you and also with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
This episode is sponsored by Evolve Back Resorts.